Welcome to the 2019 Feeder Masters Final. Behind me is Upper Tamar Lake, the new Wembley of feeder fishing. 2-day final is going to take place here with a winner walking away with a whopping £12,000. It's not just all about the winner though, the top 20 will get a payout. It's an absolutely fantastic event. Let's talk a little bit about the format. It's a weight competition, so the winner will need the biggest weight over the 2 days. It's a 2-day final. The match is split into two halves. You've got the Devon Bank and the Cornwall Bank of Tamar. And the angler will visit each side, and whoever amasses the biggest weight over the 2 days will walk away the Feeder Masters champion. Here's all the action. Enjoy. So Adam, we're here, Tamar Lakes, ready to do battle. How are you feeling?
Yeah, I'm alright, champ.
Reigning champ.
Yeah, it's always, you know, it's always all these things qualifying as always. You know, you battled through the rounds, luckily got through to won the second round at Boston, so it's great to be back here again.
So what do you think? What, give us a guess of the winning weight, come on.
I reckon 2 days, £72.
Yeah.
£72, £73, I think.
Yeah. What we're thinking? Loads of fish?
Yeah, it's going to be very tight. You've only got lucky yesterday. You know, pounds is going to be massive. There was a lot of weights. You know, even like ounces was massive. Some sections yesterday, there was a lot of them had 25 pound and ounces. And you know, that's how tight it's going to be.
Lovely, lovely, lovely. So what would it mean to you to lift this title again?
You know, the name's already on it. So to do it again, 2 years on the bounce would be brilliant. It'll be very, very hard on a venue like this. Obviously, last year I had... I had two very good pegs and caught the fish. It's not going to be that easy this year. You're going to have to get it right. It's going to be very tactical. Obviously, there's not as many bigger fish to get you out of the crap, like, as we say, but you know, it's, you've got to put a fish in your net every chuck if you can.
Brilliant.
Well, interesting area today. I am on peg 32 in the Preston Innovations Feeder Masters Grand Final. It was a good area yesterday in the practice match. There were some 20 pound weights here. It's going to be ever such a close final. The difficulty is really deciding what I'm going to target. There's a lot of roach in this venue and there's a lot of skimmers. We've got Will Freeman on the end peg. I'll get that in now just in case he hammers me. And the youngest competitor we've ever had, Charlie Richards, 14 years old, on my right, so he's going to keep me on my toes as well. So really looking forward to the final. It's going to be a great first day. Keep yourself in contention, hopefully, or maybe even a nice big winning weight. Let's see how we get on.
Thank you. So we're here with Feeder Masters day one match winner, Gareth Lambert. Gaz, how's it gone?
It's gone all right, actually. Predicted to draw that peg and I've done it, and I've drawn it right.
So you've been on peg 41?
41, yeah.
Yeah, peg you really fancied. Why is it such a good one?
I don't know, I just think the area is at the right depth of water where them fish want to be, like, at the right distance, so.
Absolutely perfect. Yeah. But we had skimmers today.
Skimmers, yeah, yeah.
How many fish have you had?
Roughly 50 odd, I thought, 55 to 60.
What sort of range have you fished today?
26 metres.
They've come late though, haven't they?
Yeah, yeah, 2.5 hours ago. I've got 5 skimmers and some ropes, and it's just started going around every cast.
Yeah, yeah. So, obviously, day two tomorrow. Absolutely in the hunt. Where do you fancy?
Somewhere down this first section here, these 5 pegs, yeah. 26 to 30.
Catch yourself some skimmers.
Yeah, hopefully, yeah.
Brilliant. Well done, mate.
All right, cheers.
Good luck tomorrow.
Cheers.
So here we are, day two, gents. The top two in front of me. How are we feeling, boys?
Good, good. Brilliant day yesterday. And all you can ask for in these two-day competitions that you're still in the race for day two. So obviously really happy what I've caught yesterday. So all to play for today.
And Dean, you're going to the section where there's a good chance of skimmers today, aren't you?
Yeah, definitely, yeah. Really dodged a bullet from where we drew yesterday. It fished a lot better than we thought it would do. So going to the place on the Devon bank where they caught quite a few skimmers yesterday, but the wind's changed round. It's a warmer wind, anything can happen. That's the beauty of these two-day competitions. You're never out of it until the final whistle.
And you, Gareth, where are you going today?
I'm going on the Cornwall bank. I'd like to draw somewhere where Dean was and in the early numbers, really,
yeah.
5 to 10, something like
there's
that.
There's loads of roach caught in your bank. Yeah. Is that something you're going to have a look at? Or?
I'll have to, I think so, yeah. I'll have to learn how to do it very quickly.
So it's really, really tight, isn't it? The top 20 is ridiculously close.
Yeah, so. I mean, like I say, the wind's changed around. It's a warmer wind, which usually means that you catch more fish. It's been an east wind, and it's fished really well on an east wind, so it could absolutely go mad today on a southwesterly. So anybody from halfway up could just, it's still anybody's. But like I say, to be in the hunt after the first day is a massive bonus in itself. So,
brilliant.
All to play for.
Well, best of luck, guys.
Cheers, Joe.
Cheers, Joe.
See you later. Great day yesterday.
Yeah.
How are you feeling about today, mate?
Reasonably confident. It's not one of the pegs I wanted, but I know there's some skimmers here, so drawn one of the noted pegs called the quarry.
Yeah.
Peg 14. So hopefully we can catch a few. It suits me. I'm not a fast roach angler, so I can't catch roach quick, so skimmers is good. So yeah, fingers crossed, hopefully we catch a few.
So obviously what weight are you on from yesterday?
So I got 33.4 yesterday. Third currently.
Yeah.
So hopefully, I think another 30 pound weight, see me right up there. So
peg two, Joe. It's an interesting area. Darren Cox was on the end peg one yesterday and caught a fantastic 30 pound of roach. Now, I think there's more roach up this end because it's shallower, but obviously that means there's a lack of skimmers. So I've got roach as my main focus today. I caught some roach in the practice match, but it was completely different. The wind was at this bank a bit, and that was the case here yesterday. There was a nice breeze here, but as you can see, it swung round and it's a bit flat close in, so you just don't know. To give you an idea of how much this place changes, last week Matt Hilly was peg two, which was incidentally the peg further down, next peg up, and he caught 40 pound skimmers. So in 1 week, the skimmers have moved from here all the way up to the other end. So there's nothing to say that they haven't even moved back today. So
The plan is start for roach and see how we get on. If we can catch 20 pound or more, we're gonna have a good chance of getting in the frame, and if it goes really well, you never know. Got a chance, so we'll see.
DC, what are you saying? Bucky's favourite, I'm saying.
There's a few favourites in this match, isn't there? It's the right field, isn't it? Some good anglers on good pegs today, so I've drawn okay. If I was being really picky, I'd rather be there, but God, in a field like this, being on this bit where there are a few fish, then I've got half a chance, mate.
So obviously peg 41 is where Gareth won the match from yesterday.
Yeah.
You've got 30 pound, that brilliant net of roach you had yesterday. So you just need to have a splendid day.
Just give me 30 pound again, and I'll whatever anyone else catches, then I think I've probably done the best I can. It'd be lovely to catch 35, but I think it's a big ask today. It's a little bit snaggy, this peg, that's one of the problems. You lose a few fish.
So is it, obviously I don't want to fry too much, but is it more of a skimmer of salt here rather than
Yeah, absolutely. Or? Yeah, yeah. It will be a skimmer of salt. It's got to be to have to build the right weight up, mate.
So best of luck, mate.
Thank you.
And we'll see you later.
Cheers. Thanks a lot.
Put your hands together for 2019 Feeder Master Lee Kerr.
Well, that smells delightful. Go on, give us a go. Look.